Hi guys, and welcome to another edition of the EduTuesday video series brought to you by the team here at Ignite Search. Okay, so today I'm actually going to talk about a very, very important topic, one that can save you not just thousands, but tens of thousands of dollars. Okay, so over the years, and it still happens even now, we get asked to go into projects, pitch for projects around digital marketing, in particular around search engine optimization. Now, when we go into this pitch, we suddenly realize that this SEO requirement has come out as a result of a need from a current website build, whether or not it's an entirely new website build or just a redesign of a current website. Now, in this case, and unfortunately, in too many cases, when we come in and start to talk to them about SEO, they've already either halfway completed the site, almost completed the site, in some cases already finished the website and launched. And this is actually not ideal from a project workflow perspective, because what tends to happen is that, say for example, a client finishes up the website, builds, right? Looks all pretty, it's great. Then they ask the SEO guys, like us, to come in. And then we do our thing. So we do things like research, we find out what keywords they want, and then we do things like website audit. And then we come up with recommendations. And of course, because SEO was not a consideration, was not part of the process during the web design phase, right? What we end up doing is we end up generating all these recommendations, we'll present to them, and these are the best practices, right? And the clients, right, will actually end up paying more just to get the website redesigned. And that could be very, very frustrating, right? So that could be something that could potentially happen to any business. And we don't want that to happen to businesses out there. We don't want it to happen to you. So as best practices, when you're approaching both web design and SEO, if you're already looking to get a website search engine optimized and you want it search engine friendly when you're doing the redesign, right, then I highly recommend that you actually consider SEO, right, at the very start of the project, even before you begin the web design project. Because if you do this research and the strategy, and we propose the website structures, we pretty much bake in or build in SEO into the website firm, right? Not only we have the cost savings of tens of thousands of dollars, right, of actually having all the SEO features and the right structure and the right content already part of the website. When you launch the website, right, you can actually expect equal, even better results when you launch. So typically, a well-crafted SEO website as part of the web design, right, when done correctly as part of launch, can expect greater results. So jumps of visibility, traffic, and conversions. Yeah. So this is just a bit of a spiel. I hope that if you're already listening to this and you're already about to embark on this journey, please come and speak to us, right? Come and speak to us before you start, and let us show you, let me teach you what we can do at this stage. If you're not doing anything at the moment, that's fine, right? Keep this in mind for you and your team, that in the event that you ever want to do web design down in the future, right, think of SEO as your first thing and not your last thing. And you're going to thank me for it. Thank you so much for listening. I appreciate it, right? And until next time, I'll see you guys around. Bye.